I am a sports person. I come from Kenya. I just want to say greetings to my friends from Holland. My first races, I ran in Egmond Sea. My first half marathon, I did not know how to run, but I managed. I come from Kenya in a conflict area. I know people love me as a champion. Yes, I am a champion. I used to run to school, fighting with the family so that I can do sports, but it was not easy from this community. But I was happy because I had a strong backbone as a woman. That was my mother. When I came to Europe, I saw wonderful things that made my heart to think of, what can I do back home? I need to do something. I need to have a name. And then I went back home. My federation did not like me because I come from a very conflict area. The only woman or a man who came from this area. My district is bigger than Holland. But to have that woman, a small girl, to do sports, it was not good for others. Okay, I came to Germany. I say I want to run, to run for my community, but it wasn't my community. When you come to Europe, I'm sorry to say this, they say, oh, most of the African women, they cannot do well. But I say, eh, do I have two legs like the other women? I say, you know what, I have to do something straight. I struggled because there was also other women who were encouraging me, not only my Kenyan women, but other women from Europe. I had a woman from Holland and then one woman from Norway. Her name is Ingrid Christensen. What happened is I won the Rotterdam and I broke the world record. Taking the Ingrid Christensen the world record. It was not enough for me. I was the first African woman to win New York Marathon. Again, it was not there. It was not enough. I was thinking of education of our women. I was thinking, how am I going to change life for the others? Okay, I went back home. In 2003, I started the Tegla Loroupe peace race. Why I started this event is that I was in Morocco when there was a bombing in Casablanca. And then there was a day before, after the race. For me, I say, you know what? There are people who love sports. I went into Indonesia after the bomb blast. The Americans, the Australians, they refused their athlete to go there. But the Minister of Sport asked me, will you come? I say, yes, I will do it because I come from a conflict area. And if I can do something to bring sanity, and I will not say no. And then I went there. It was not enough. I said, you know what, I have to do something home. In my area, we had many Sudanese. We had also including the late Dr. Gakara. They used to say, the little Tegla, she is protecting these people. I never met with the Dr. Gakara. But because of the name that I had it, you can get all the names. But for me, I say, you know what, I have to do something again. When we organize this event, I can say that it never happened in those areas. I use sports. The president of Uganda, Yoweri Museveni, and the president of Kenya, the other one sent somebody from Uganda, I want you to go and support that girl. It never happened in our region. If this small girl can do that, we started that event. And I saw multitude of child soldiers that our government were not able to disengage them. But through sports, I took that chance. But I was clever enough to talk to our government and tell them, you know what? If I was able to, from this community, where they used to say, she's a daughter of a warlord, but now I am the daughter of Kenya. I'm the daughter of the world, a woman who represents other women. So these people who are fighting, we need to understand why they are fighting. And if I will be able to tell one person, to disarm one person, because one person is a leader of many, please help me to disarm their minds. So we were able to collect guns because of that trust. They did not trust the government, but I became very loyal to my government, saying, you know what, I will never work alone. We need what we call reconciliation. We need the heart of forgiveness. Don't be happy when you see a bad person being put in prison. Be happy if you can change that person to understand why he was doing wrong things. So most of our warriors surrendered the guns to us. We give the guns to the government and we give the education. I try to sponsor some of the kids to school, but they say, can you build a school for us that we can own? I talk about when my brother from Sudan say, you know what? It's very important to make people to be part of the project that we are doing, but don't involve people. So we have a school of 400 kids. For me, I realized that the Sudanese kids are my brothers, and nobody applied to be a refugee. So I used to train them, but for me, I go to Europe. For them, they stay home. So one time when Dr. Thomas Bach became the president of IEC, he knew what I was doing against the odds. He told me that, like, with the struggle, we have struggled. I want to help the refugees to run Rio. So what can we do? I said, I'm going to talk with the UNHCR. If we can do something in Kakuma, whereby there are so many refugees. But my intention is to get few of the refugees, when they start running, they will have a better education also, not only to come, but just a pathway. One thing that I really want to tell my government is that of that trust alone, to bring a refugee from that camp, it's not easy. But I was able to be given these 35 people. So when we went to Rio, before we went to Rio, I had a lot of a negative toward the refugees that I had. They say, she is working with the bad people. She is doing with that. But for me, because I was one of the, a woman or a girl, they used to say she comes from a very bad community. But here I am, then I have the name. To be given ambassador by Kofi Annan, it's something big for the continent and for the whole world. So the refugee became the best people in Rio. How many years? The refugee people have been there in the whole world, nobody think of helping them. But I did not want to take the credit, but my credit to see some of them today are really ambassadors. And what we are teaching our people is that learn something, go back home. If I was another weak person, I could have stayed in Germany where I was training. But my home is more important because I was able to change something. I was able to change kids. I was able to change the perception of my government. And everybody, as I want to tell the youths before I sit down, they say you are the leaders for tomorrow. We are leaders for today. But we need all our people together. We need elders to learn from them. We need our government to learn from them. So we cannot build a world without them. But we can build a world when we bring that sanity. I want to see the future of people have the forgiveness of heart and help one another. Somebody talk about Yemen. How many of us are rich here? Can we at least contribute and send food than putting things in the Facebook alone? What have we done as a person? What have I done as Tegla to contribute? It's a challenge for all of us. I just want to say, let's peace prevail. And those who always cause war are very poor in heart. Why? Because they never send their kids. The poor people send their kids. The middle class send their kids for war. But the rich one, they stay home and send their kids to study outside. May God bless you. Thank you very much.